Hey there, my name is Ayden, and today we're going to be discussing about light fidelity. Let's get on with it. Before we break things down, let's get some sort of feel for what light fidelity really is about. Light fidelity is a process in which data transmission occurs from the transmitter to the receiver, where the intended message is converted from binary into a single product, such as alphabetical letters or even musical notes. You can consider them to, in fact, be a substitute for Wi-Fi, where Wi-Fi uses radio signal waves, whereas light fidelity uses patterns of light to make data transmission possible. Well, let's start to be more specific. Light and fidelity. The system requires visible light, and just like its name suggests, light which enables you to see your surroundings, as well as light that you can actually see with your own naked eye. Well, the more common term to describe visible light is the fact that it is both a wave and a particle. It is also an electromagnetic radiation of a wavelength. You can imagine them to in fact be packets of energy, floating and cruising all around you, but at the speed of light. And if you put it into measurement, it's 100 million times faster than a rocket. See? Communicative fidelity is a process in which a transmitter sends a message to the receiver, and the receiver will have to interpret the message from binary into a single product, such as alphabetical letters or the product you seek, like musical notes. In this case, our transmitter, such as LED light bulbs, will simply have to transmit data using patterns of light, and it will shine over the receiver. And the receiver's job is to simply interpret the patterns of light from binary, and eventually the system will just convert binary into alphabetical letters. With these two words combined, we can come to understand that there's an important and accurate connection between the transmitting and the receiving process, and that the transmitter's job is simply to shine patterns of light into the receiver. And as you can infer, the receiver's job is to detect for visible light spectrum and convert it into binary information. Here I bring a common example that is used in most light fidelity projects. The aim of the system I've built is to send alphabetical words or strings from one laptop connected to a transmitter to a laptop connected to a receiver. The method I've used is the Manchester encoding system, which represents 0 by one type of stage and 1 by another type of stage, allowing us to differentiate between 0 and 1 bit. We first have something called bit periods, so take a look at this table. The bit periods are separated into two intervals. A zero would have the presence of high voltage, in other words, on in the first interval, and low voltage, or rather off in the second interval. One would be the reverse order. Keep in mind that this is both very interchangeable and simply just depends on your program.
So I'm just gonna send a message to the receiving laptop. How are you doing?
Familiar with the Manchester encoding system, let's break this down. How are we going to interpret and translate light patterns into binary digits? The idea is to make use of bit periods, or intervals, as well as a simple formula for what 0 equals to and what 1 equals to. Since binary numbers consist of only zeros and ones, it then only requires us to use two intervals. We can use this in many ways based on our program, in which one example is when a 1 would detect for a high voltage, which signifies the presence of light in the first interval,
whereas low voltage signifies the absence of light in the second interval. Zero would be the reverse order. Here's what it would look like in an app called Logic, which helps graphically represent a process. This is a visual representation of light fidelity programming in C++ terms. The structure of the program should look something like this. We begin with data input from the user, such as taking in an area of char or even a musical note. For your information, an array of char is simply a sequence of alphabetical letters stored in an array. Then, for every character in an array, input of I, we convert this into a binary integer and push this into the ith index of a binary array. Eventually, we send LED light patterns to the receiver based on the sequence of binary digits stored on the index I. Finally, we convert the received binary integers on index I of binary array of the receiver into alphabets, getting our final product. Now, for your formula, 0 would equal to an off percent on, whereas a 1 would equal to an on percent off. And if you want to check for the credibility of this whole process, you can simply check for the first array of binary integers of I, and if it's equal to binary integer of 2, then the whole converting process throughout this LED light patterns is accurately transmitted. So the functions would be data input, binary conversion, LED pattern from the transmitter, receive panel, binary to the original message in the receiver process. Your subtask 1 is to take each alphabetical letter or your char of the input into an array called ARR of input. And the explanation is, taking letter by letter is much more systematic, because if you get an input as hello world, you can't input it directly as the binary of zeros and ones would be completely mixed up. This would be right, whereas this would be wrong, because this would be converted into some random letter or char, whereas this would be converted to correct values, a separate amount of values. And you take the input letter by letter, and you restructure this whole intended message. And for your information, what data structures can you perhaps use? You could use an array, which is the most common type, a map, which has the ability to access negative indexes, or even a vector, which doesn't require you to initialize the beginning size of the whole data structure. And we name this AR of input. Then we look at the binary value at the ith index, and we name this binary array. And for every ith character, we convert this into a binary integer or product. And these are just some example values. Then we allow the transmitting light patterns to the receiver. Recap, we take data input from the user, alphabetical to binary conversion, LED light, and we binary conversion, and we get our final product.
We're not fully aware of how capable light fidelity will be in the future, but one thing's for sure, it's definitely an evolutionary Internet of Things, and the time will eventually come to pass where we will use it in our everyday lives. Data transmission will be revolutionized, and one thing's for sure, it's going to be substituting Wi-Fi in the future. So see you 10 years in the future. Thanks for watching.